Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and entertaining simple. I hope you've been having a great summer. Today I'm going to show you how I've organized the freezer part of my side-by-side fridge. A couple weeks ago I did organization videos of the door of the fridge and inside the refrigerator. So if you're interested in seeing those videos, I'll put it in the iCards above. So the freezer is to the left of the refrigerator and I don't have a deep freezer. So this is all the freezer space that I have. And I've tweaked it a little bit by using new bins and just making sure that what I'm using for that week or the next week and a half are things that I'm going to use.
Okay, here is the fridge in my kitchen. To the left is the coffee station area. To the right is the toaster oven and the pantry, and my family room is over there. So when you open it up, the main change I made was switching out the bins that I had here before. So this is kind of an overview of what the side-by-side freezer part of my fridge looks like. I hope that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 little shelves here in the door area, and this is where the ice comes out, so that takes up a lot of space. I definitely use labels in the freezer because I forget, honestly, where to put things, and then when things are empty, I'm like, now what did I have in there? And then it helps my family to put things back in place. And these are items that obviously we eat for breakfast, and they're things that are pretty much grab and go. So here are sausage biscuits. This fun reusable bag I got on Amazon, I love it. It came like in a pack of 12 or something. And so I take things out of the box. This is a great bag if you're looking for an option like that. Next are ice packs, and because this shelf is so skinny, okay, there's barely anything else to put in here. Obviously we don't use ice packs all the time, but when we do use them, I can grab them here. Of course, if I needed this space, I could put these here with the ice cubes, but since I don't need anything else to put in here and it's such a skinny shelf anyway, I go ahead and keep the ice packs there. We always have ice cream year round. We love ice cream. And then someone had brought this over for a dinner that we had, and so we've had that there. And then I have a couple of these Dove ice cream stuff, little ice cream bites. So I labeled it other because it can be anything there. It can even be like a leftover that I froze that we want to eat later. And then down here under other, yes, I'm sorry, I love White Castle cheeseburgers. I'm from the Chicago area and that's the only way I can have them once in a while. And trust me, this summer I have just been like White Castle crazy. I make our own ice. I could probably get one more tray, but I don't want to block the light. Because this refrigerator is 14 years old, and a few years ago, the ice maker broke. And the guy said, it's cheaper for you to buy a whole new refrigerator than try to fix that. It's still working, and we just make our own ice. And I just put it in there. So obviously this takes a lot of space. And because there's not a lot of space in this type of refrigerator, I have to be very thoughtful of what I'm gonna put in here and how I'm gonna put it. So the main thing that I changed here is to use these bins. I think I mentioned that already. So these were in my laundry room, and I went ahead and got the same bins for the freezer and tested them out, and they're pretty strong. Like other plastic containers, they've gotten brittle and they've broken off. But these have been good. So here you can see it says smoothie packs. And I'm just gonna take this out and show you what's in it. So here you can see they are Ziploc bags, but we reuse them because it's just fruit and kale. So it's 4 strawberries, 1 whole banana that we've chopped up, and we put in a bunch of kale. So we just grab this in the morning and throw it into the Ninja blender, and that's our smoothie. So this fits about 8, okay. There's 7 in here right now, but it looks like that. So this is pretty much good for about half a week, and I have to do this again. This takes about 20 minutes to prep because of the cutting and putting things into the bags, but it's a lot easier that way than to have to chop things individually every morning. I have this labeled vegetarian vegetables, Asian entrees, snacks, and then meat and seafood. I took a cutting board and I created a shelf, okay? And you can use maybe like a baking tray, but I like to use a cutting board or maybe even a piece of wood. And you see how it creates a whole new shelf for my lumpia wrappers, egg roll wrappers. And basically it's bread and things that we like to use in the air fryer. By the way, guys, the air fryer is awesome. I need to do a review of that one time. But this summer, we are loving French fries and tater tots and hash browns. Someone brought this for a dinner. I gotta use that up. And I'm using the same reusable bags because, like I said, I take everything out of the boxes because boxes take up a lot of space. And I put it in here. Okay, so even here, pizza rolls. And these are sweet potato fries. They are fantastic in the air fryer. And then hash browns. So you can see that these have been our snacks during the summertime. And you can see the size of the bin there. And it fits all this stuff very nicely. And it fits the whole length of the shelf here. So here's another small bin. And this one has entrees, like example that, taquitos. This one is one of those undershelf baskets. Undershelf basket there. And it just slips onto the shelf above it. This one I've labeled Asian. And so it has our spring rolls in here, banana spring rolls and other spring rolls. So it just hooks onto here. So the problem with that one is it's not long enough. So I might have to find one that's longer. And it sits on this basket actually. And here's some more Asian stuff. You guys like that? Dried fish. Okay, you see how it goes on there? And it creates a whole new shelf there. Or I could try to look for another one of these shelves that can go on this one. Mainly Filipino veggies here. Green peas, because I'm always using green peas for some of the Indian recipes that I like to make. And Filipino ones. Okay, so that is my freezer organization. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave me a comment below and let me know what you have done differently in your freezer organization. Share some of your tips with the other people in this community. And if you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing if you like decluttering, organizing, and cleaning videos. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.